بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. We're continuing in the readings of Kitab al-Siyam from the book Bulugh al-Maram من أدلة الأحكام ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله تعالى. It's been explained by Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala. And we left off last night mentioning the hadith concerning the excellence of As-Sahur. And that is the hadith on the authority of Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, who said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Tasahharu fa inna fi as-sahur barakah." To take that meal that is right before Fajr, before beginning the fast, or at the latter part of the night, because indeed in a sahur, in that meal, in that time, in that action, there is barakah. And we mentioned what the Shaykh he presented concerning the issues of the barakat of a sahur and the tremendous different blessings that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has placed within this particular action and this food that one takes before he begins his fast. And from the benefits of this hadith is ithbatul baraka fi ba'd al-at'ima, is the affirmation of barakah, of blessings in some foods, is the affirmation of blessings in some of the things that we eat. فَإِنَّ فِي السَّهُورِ بَرَكَةٌ. The Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that there is barakah in as-sahur. وَإِذَا كَانَ السَّهُورُ بَرَكَةٌ وَهُوَ طَعَامٌ فَقَدْ يَكُونُ فِي الْإِنسَانِ أَيْضًا بَرَكَةٌ وَذَلِكَ بِأَنْ يَكُونَ الْإِنسَانُ مُبَارَكًا عَلَى مَنْ لَهُ اتِّصَالُ بِهِ. And the Shaykh he also mentions, just likewise, if the sahur, there is barakah in it, and it is food, also within individuals, within people, likewise there is barakah, there is blessings in individuals. And that is that an individual can be mubarakan upon those who meet him, upon those who he interacts with, upon those who comes in contact with this individual. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has mentioned in his book, and those who they may become mubarakan, and they may be people who are people of barakah, or people who have been given barakah, wherever they may be. Some of the ulama, they say this means the people who are mu'allimul khayr, people who teach the people goodness. And also from the benefits of this hadith is husnu ta'aleem al-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam li qawnihi yuqrinu al-hukm bil-illah, or yuqarrinu al-hukm bil-illah. And this is from the benefits of this hadith, the excellence in the manner in which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach, by combining the ruling along with its reason. Combining the ruling along with its reason. Its reason. What is the ruling? Tasahharu, the amr, the command to take sahur. This is a ruling that people should take sahur. What is the illah? Because in sahur is barakah. This is the reason. Also from the benefits of this hadith, and we conclude with these particular benefits, is it shows the tremendous excellence and the high lofty status of the Sharia. The high and lofty status of the Sharia. And the way that it shows that is أن الشريعة لا تعمر ولا تنهى إلا لحكمة, is that the legislation, the Sharia of Al-Islam, there's nothing that the Sharia commands us to do or nothing that it prohibits us from, except that there is a wisdom behind that. Secondly, al-qiyas إِذَا وُجِدَتِ الْإِلَّا فِي الْفُرُوعِ وَفِي الْفَرْءِ الْمُقَيِّسِ or مُقِيس. Also, taken from this, more benefits is al-qiyas. When the إِلَّا is found, that one can take this إِلَّا here, يعني إِمْكَانُ الْحَقَ غَيْرَهُ بِهِ. That one can take this إِلَّا or take an إِلَّا and connect it to something that resembles it, or something that can be attached to it with another situation or another ruling. ثالثة, also زيادة إطمئنان المكلف. المكلف, also the increase of bringing tranquility and bringing contentment to the person who has been given the obligation, or the obligation has been placed, or the responsibility has been placed upon them. Those people who are sane, those people who are Muslim first, sane adults, the obligation and the responsibility that has been placed upon them to carry out this obligation of Allah Ta'ala of fasting. So these are from the benefits of that hadith. We'll get ready to stop here tonight before we move on to the next hadith. And we just mentioned that hadith, and that is the hadith under the issue that Ibn Hajar brings, istihbab al-fitr ala tamrin aw ma'in. The preference of breaking one's fast upon dates or water. Upon dates or water. And that is the hadith on the authority of Salman ibn Amir al-Dabi, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, إذا أفطر أحدكم فليفطر على تمر فإن لم يجد فليفطر على ماء فإنه طهور. رواه الخمسة وصححه ابن خزيمة وابن حبان والحاكم. This hadith states here on the authority of Salman ibn Amr al-Dabi, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, and Allah Ta'ala knows best concerning this particular narration and its narrator. Because one thing that I noticed here, that, and that's what I, even though I just said it, that there's no statement of radiyallahu anhu from this individual that narrated this hadith, as you find it mentioned in the other narrations, where it mentions in the text after him. It could be it was left out by mistake, or it could be that this individual was not a sahabi. And the reason why I say that is because I looked and I searched and tried to find in some of the books of Rijal and Tarajim of the Sahaba and the individuals who are in the chains of narrations, like Isaba of Fitamyiz al-Sahaba, the book with regards to mentioning all of the Sahaba and the names of the Sahaba, as well as Usd al-Ghaba. And I have not found this individual. I have not found who this individual is. And Ibn Uthaymeen, he also mentions that there's only a few from amongst the names of the Sahaba with the names of Salman. There are only a few with the name Salman. So I cannot find him from amongst the characterizations of the names of the Sahaba in some of these books. But it says, عن سلمان بن عامر الضبي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and doesn't say رضي الله عنه, so Allah Ta'ala knows best. But he says that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, إذا أفطر أحدكم, when any of you breaks his fast, فليفطر على تمرين, then let him break his fast upon dates, or upon a date. If he does not find that, then let him break his fast with water. فَإِنَّهُ طَهُورٌ, because this water is something that is purifying. It is pure and it is purifying. And we'll get into the meaning of this for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam concerning breaking one's fast on tamar and breaking one's fast with ma, and the way that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also mentioned here the reason for breaking it with water, another illa, فَإِنَّهُ طَهُورٌ, because it is pure and it is purifying. So we'll stop here بإذن الله عز وجل tonight. هذا والله أعلم, وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.